Part 8, Trade Discount and Cash Discount. Trade discount is an allowance given by the seller to the buyer in order to encourage the buyer to buy in bulk or large quantity. Trade discount is allowed to all customers and there is no record in the book of account for trade discount. Trade discount is also allowed at the time of purchase or sale. Cash discount is an allowance given by the seller to the buyer to encourage the buyer to make prompt payment. Two types of cash discount are discount allowed and discount received. But cash discount is not allowed to all customers. Only customer who made a prompt payment will be given cash discount. And the record should be made for both discount received and discount allowed in the income statement or statement of profit or loss. And the entry will be made at the time of payment. Example 4.19, January 18, bought good worth RM2,000 on credit. So, since the business purchased good, the amount of expenses increased. Increase in expense, debit. We need to open purchase account and make an entry into the debit side. So, in debit side, the date is January 18 and the particular is Amina Trading because the purchase was made to Amina Trading amounted to RM1,900. Why RM1,900 not RM2,000? Because we need to deduct the trade discount from the original price. The original price is RM2,000. The trade discount, the rate is 5%. So 5% times RM2,000 is equivalent to 100. Therefore, 2,000 minus 100 is equal to RM1,900. The second effect is when the business bought good on credit, the amount of liability increased. Therefore, credit account payable Amina Trading. So, we need to open a new account name account payable Amina Trading and make the entry in the credit side. So, in credit side, you can see here the date is January 18. Particular is purchase, which means that the credit purchase is made from Amina Trading amounted to RM1,900. Example 4.20, January 19, sold good. So, when the business sold good, the amount of revenue increase. Increase in revenue will be credited. So, you need to credit account sale. Okay, for the sold good, open a new account named sales. So, in sales account, the entry will be made in the credit side. So, the date is 19 January. Particular is account receivable Abdul because the business sold good on credit to Abdul. Therefore, Abdul become the debtor of the business. The amount is RM2,850. Why we use this figure to the 2,850, not 3,000? Because you need to deduct the amount of original price with the trade discount of 5%. The original price is RM3,000. The trade discount percentage is 5%. RM3,000 times 5% is RM150. So RM3,000 minus RM300, RM150 is equal to RM2,850. When the business sold good to Abdul on credit, the asset of the business, which is account receivable Abdul, will increase. Since the asset increase, account receivable Abdul need to be debited with the amount of RM2,850. The date is 19 January and the particular is sale. It mean that the credit sale was made to account receivable Abdul. And before we go further into cash discount, we need to understand the journal entry for cash discount. There are two types of cash discount. First is discount received. Discount received is a revenue. That is why discount received need to be credited, because revenue increase is credit, and we need to debit the account payable, because the discount received will reduce the liability of the business. And for discount allowed, it is an expense. So since there is an increase in expense, debit discount allowed account. And the discount allowed will reduce the amount of the debtor or the amount of account receivable. That's why account receivable will be credited, because asset decrease credit. Yeah. Example 4.21, January 31st, paid by cheque the amount owed to Aminah Trading and receive cash discount 2%. When the business paid the amount owed to Aminah Trading, the total amount of liability will decrease. Okay, so decrease in liability debit. In account payable Aminah Trading, the record will be made in the debit side. So refer to this entry, January 31st, discount received RM38. So how to get this RM38? You need to calculate the cash discount 2% from the amount owed to Aminah Trading. From the previous example on January 18, the purchase made to Aminah Trading is amounted to RM1,900. So RM1,900 times 2% is equivalent to RM38. So this RM38 need to be deducted from the account payable Aminah Trading. Therefore, our liability, the business liability to Aminah Trading will be reduced. Okay, instead of RM1,900, it will be reduced by RM38. Okay, next. When the business receive cash discount. Cash discount received is a revenue. So when the business receive cash discount, the revenue will be increased. Increase in revenue is credit. So in discount receive account, the entry will be made in the credit side, January 31st. Particular is account payable Aminah Trading, which means that the discount is received from Aminah Trading amounted to RM38. And for the third effect is asset decrease, which is bank. Why asset bank decrease? Because the business need to pay Aminah Trading by check. So the amount of bank will be decreased. So decrease in asset is credit. So refer to the credit side of bank account. These are the previous entries for the previous example. Yeah? Just focus on 31st January. Okay, for 31st January, in the credit side of bank account, we have Aminah Trading, which means that the check was paid to Aminah Trading amounted to RM1,862. So where do I get the amount of RM1,862? Okay, since the amount of purchase is RM1,900, right? And then the discount received from Aminah Trading is RM38. Therefore, the remaining balance after you deduct the amount of purchase RM1,900 from with the discount received RM38. So the remaining balance that need to be paid by the business to Aminah Trading is equivalent to RM1,862. Or you can calculate this amount by deducting the amount owed to Aminah Trading, which is RM1,900, with the amount of discount received from Aminah Trading at RM38. So RM1,900 minus 38 is equivalent to 1862. And for example 4.22, on 31st January, Abdul, which is the debtor or account receivable of the business, settle amount owed by check. So which means that the debtor will give check to the business. So the debtor give check to the business, the amount of bank will increase. So increase in asset will be debited. In the debit side of bank account, you can see that the transaction on 31st January, the particular is account receivable Abdul, and the amount is 2793. So to get the amount, you need to deduct the amount owed by the Abdul, by Abdul, 2850. This is the sale made to Abdul on 19 January, yeah. And then minus with the discount allowed to Abdul, amounted to 57 ringgit, which is discount allowed equal to 2850 times 2%, equivalent to 57. 2850 minus 57 is equal to 2793. So this is the amount need to be paid by Abdul to the business by check. And the second effect is that when the business gave Abdul discount, it need to be recorded as an expense, yeah. When expense incurred, there is an increase in expense, so debit. The entry for discount allowed will be made in the debit side. Okay, so January 31st, particular is account receivable Abdul. The amount is 57. To get 57, the amount owed by Abdul is 2850, because previously the business sold the good on 19 January at 2850. So the 2850 time with the rate of cash discount at 2%. Therefore, we get 57. Next effect is decrease in asset. Why? Because the amount of discount allowed to Abdul will reduce the amount owed by Abdul to the business, right? Since the amount of account receivable reduce or decrease, we need to credit that transaction. So for account receivable Abdul account, in the credit side, you see here on January 31st, the particular is bank, okay, amounted to 2793. Okay, 2793, which is 2850 minus 57. So this is the amount that need to be paid by Abdul to the business by check. So that's the end of part 8.